You know what this is.
We'll play by ear.
What's going on, y'all? It's Mike Silva from Don't At Me, part of the repertoire. What are we doing here? Well, going to give you a snippet of the last episode of Don't At Me, just to kind of give you an idea of what to expect from the upcoming podcast, Play It By Ear. Trying to generate some buzz. We have a new podcast joining the network. Of course, we introduced you all to it with a little bit of a teaser last week. But it's going to be Play It By Ear. The feed should be available next week. We're supposed to have episodes going up next week. So keep an eye out. Of course, once the feed is available, we'll send it your way so you can subscribe. This isn't an excerpt from a Play It By Ear episode. This is from the last Don't At Me, but it's kind of in that same ballpark of what we're going to talk about. It's going to be music conversations, debates on all-time albums. You know, Chance and I already have plenty of gripes, so I'm sure that we'll get into plenty of debates on this show. We're also going to get into, introducing you all to songs and playlists, things that have really just kind of resonated with us. What have we been playing on repeat for the last couple of months? You know me, I'll play something until I can't stand it anymore. But I'll let you guys get into the clip. Again, reason we're here, this is right up the alley of what you'll hear on Play It By Ear. This one kind of dissects why people hate Drake. What is it? Why does everybody hate Champagne Poppy? We dive into some of our theories, and Antonio actually defends Drake a little bit. Make sure you stay tuned. And again, once we have the feed, I'll send it out so everybody can do us a solid and subscribe. You'll stay in the loop on everything that we're putting out. Spotify, Apple Podcasts, Google Play, Stitcher, wherever you listen to podcasts. Let us know what you think, too. Rate, review, and enjoy.
Yo, all right, maybe you can even attest to this, Antonio. I don't know, like, you got any Yeezy V2s?
Yeah.
Okay, how many pairs you got?
Three.
You got three pairs, all right? Different colors, right?
Yeah.
Obviously. I mean, why would you buy the same color and shit? Yo, okay, remember when people used to talk shit about Jordans? And like, yo, he's selling you the same shoe over and over again. Kanye really finessed you selling the same shoe. He sold them shits literally for like 4 years straight.
Yeah, no, that's
and just literally changing the color.
Yeah, that's
and now, even there's some coming out this weekend that the nigga, it's the same color. It's the black ones.
Yeah, yeah.
They're coming out this weekend. It's a re-release.
Wait,
he's selling you the same shit.
What about maybe 2 months ago? He re-released all the ones that he released over the past 2 years.
Right.
You remember that? And they all sold out.
Right.
Again.
So, I mean, like, I know, like, 5 or 6 years ago, like, that was, like, what people were talking about. Like, hey, is he going to change the culture, man? Because he's going to not be selling you the same shit over and over again like Jordan has been for 30 years. It's like, well, at least Jordan is selling you, like, 30 pairs of shoes over, like, 30 years. You know what I'm saying?
Kanye's like, genuine. Like, I feel like everything he does, he wants to do.
Right.
I don't think he's really manipulating people. I think he just does what he wants to do. But I feel like motherfucker's really good at finding a wave and riding it. Like,
oh,
he is
a shit show.
It's savvy. It's savvy.
Great business sense.
I mean, look like
he's been doing that shit forever.
This man opera. Made dad shoes.
Yeah.
I even got a pair.
Yeah, I mean,
he started with
the let me dress like a fucking white boy.
Yeah.
You know, like, let me dress like back in fucking 2004. Let me dress like a white boy.
He's definitely evolved.
Changed the whole shit, bro. Yeah. Like, everything, like, for real, since, I'm not gonna lie, of the first 20 years of this, like, millennium or whatever the fuck, you know what I'm saying? Like, this time, this era, the 2000s or whatever, he's the most influential person of the time.
Man, here's how I know that I agree with that.
Yep.
I mean, I'm not really, like, a religious person. I'm like, okay, I'll pray here and there. I wish I was more religious, but I'll be honest, I'm not. I've never been disappointed that I couldn't make it to church. Until I couldn't make it to Lakewood.
Straight up, nah.
Damn, man.
That's crazy, right?
Damn. I couldn't make it to church this week.
That tells
nigga,
you something.
What?
Sorry, God, but like.
Yo, I had to go see Jesus. You know what I'm saying?
I mean, he was bringing it that night, you know?
Like, for real, though. And, like, that goes to, like, what I was just saying. Like, you know, in this, like. It literally, like, the fast, he's been around for 15 years. You know what I'm saying? Like, mainstream. Like, he's literally been around our lives for 15 years. Michael Jordan was in the league for almost 15 years, 14 seasons, right? Right. His, the Bulls run or whatever. He was the most influential person at the end of that time. You know what I'm saying? The last, like, 20 years the of the fucking... Like, he was the icon.
It's not just role model. Legend,
he was just everything. Like, you know what I'm saying? Yeah. Like, he's fucking worldwide known. People that's poor, people that's rich want to, like, if not be like him, be, like, with him. Hang
instantly
out.
Instantly
like,
recognizable by everybody.
Exactly. Like... He did the same shit that Jordan did. Yeah, no, he did. Like, he literally takes every little thing. So, he does, like, the one he's always talking about with Disney and Steve Jobs and shit like that. It's like, yo, all
right. Are his competitors. That's
He just thinks that. Dude, he's the only one that
he's like, I'm going to do the same thing. They're my competition.
Yeah. Imitation is the fondest form of flattery.
You talk about how Kanye can take something, repurpose it, and just sell it over again.
Yeah.
This is going to be an unpopular take.
Except for his albums, because he's never done that before.
I like some of what this dude does. Some of it, I'm like, that's kind of cheesy. But at the end of the day, I feel like we all shit on him unfairly.
Yeah, everybody does.
Well, who I'm about to talk about. Doesn't Drake kind of do the same thing?
But Drake...
He literally did that with Care Package.
But he doesn't... Okay.
Everybody knew the songs already. That's he put thing. It out and people were banging it all summer.
He does it with music. Like I was just like I just said in the little like just off comment I
you
just
did.
Made.
I caught it.
I was like, he doesn't do it with the music, and like that's what makes Kanye so great. Like that's why Drake may be the biggest artist right now, and he kind of has been for 10 years. I'll give him that. You know what I'm saying? Yeah. Like no, like 10 straight years, he's kind of been the biggest artist, like straight up, like for real since 2011, because that's kind of when like Wayne kind of left it alone. You know what I'm saying?
Even like.
09 was like the start. Like that's what I'm saying. For a solid 10 years, he's been like, you know, solid, straight up. Like he's been the best, or whatever. Not the best in my eyes, guys. Come on,
is it Degrassi? Is that like why it's lame to like Drake?
I think it's lame to really like Drake because he makes so many soft songs. He makes not even cake, but he makes a lot of soft music.
I will actually tell you why it's lame to
but
be.
I love Drake, so I'm just this is what I hear people say.
I'll tell you as being
I
like
the music,
a
lot of the songs. Like, here's the thing I like about Drake before, because I know you're gonna shit on him. When I like Drake because like a lot of my memories, a lot of things that I like are tied to memories, right? So like his music is almost omnipresent. It fits in just about any scenario,
any time.
It's like a guilty pleasure. Time. But hey, it wears on you. People are like, man, this shit goes hard now, you know? But, like, it doesn't matter what race, ethnicity, people say, like, man, fuck Drake. But hey, a lot of time his songs come up, they'll roll the windows up, look around, and turn the fucking volume up. Don't lie, because I've heard you jamming some of his shit, too.
These awards song nonstop, why. That's it.
I don't understand why people hate on Drake so much. So I guess I'm going to hear it from you. But I'll tell you why he's top. He's one of my top five artists, right? Reason why I like Drake, because his music is so relatable. I feel like for the most part, you could find a track on every Drake album that you're like, damn, I felt that
I'm
shit.
I'm in
for
this
me
song.
Anyway. You know what I mean? Like,
I'm sitting next to him.
I remember an experience on some shit you're talking about.
Yeah.
That's why he's like, he's top artist.
Well, maybe it's lame because in order for somebody to make that admission, they have to be secure in themselves. Like, you know what? I've been vulnerable before. Yeah. I've been in these shoes. Whereas, like, it's like, man, Drake weak. I don't fuck with Drake, you know? Well, they're rolling up the window with Marvin Room, come on. All
right, see, for me, like, with it is, since kind of his rise, I mean, before, after So Far Gone, I was like, eh, fuck this guy. He, like, it's not really that appealing to me. I love So Far Gone. I remember I remember exactly who I was with. When I was with J. Carr in his fucking Lincoln with my cousin Nico sitting in front of Lil Trey House, tie boxing and shit. First time I ever heard that shit. And, like, that shit was amazing. But then I remember who the fuck he was. Like, when nigga, I was like, who is this? You know what I'm saying? Because I'm, like, jamming and shit. And then I was like, who is this? And they're like, this is a nigga Drake or whatever. I'm like, Drake? Who the fuck is Drake? They're like, man, he, like, used to be with Jazz and shit all the time. A light-skinned dude or some shit. I'm like, oh, shit. That nigga? I'm like, wait, what? Because, like, he used to always come to the vault with Jazz. Like, so I knew him kind of personally. Like, not, like, knew him, like, you know, oh, shit, what's up? You know, we dabbing up, talking and chopping it up and shit. But he was kind of around. He was kind of just like a nigga that, like, I didn't feel right around. You know what I'm saying? Like, nah, not that he was sketchy or anything like that. It's just that man, it's something about this nigga I just already don't like, bro. And I literally, from that point on, like, I mean, I love So Far Gone. Like, because it was jamming before I knew who the nigga was. You know what I'm saying? So, like, I give him that. But, like, after that, I was like, man, fuck this guy. So, I, like, never really gave him the chance to, like, actually listen to his shit. Yeah. So, I never really, like, listened to Take Care, like, the albums. Never really, like, you know, got into, I really didn't get into Drake to Scorpion.
Jesus,
you swear to God, and I only like one song. And I only like one song.
So I'll tell you, and
it's nonstop. I don't know why.
I'll tell you this. So like, Drake is my version of your In and Out, where like, I don't feel like he gets on base every time. Like he's not batting a thousand, but like all of his best. Like if I look at, it's hard for me to define a favorite song, right? Mm-hmm. Like my favorites, I'm like, all right, my definition of a favorite song is when it comes on. Yeah, I'm like, I usually don't skip it.
Yeah.
That's my definition of like an all-time favorite song, right? That doesn't mean I think it's the best song ever. That doesn't mean that I by any means think that other people agree with me. Mm-hmm. But for me, I'm like, I don't skip this much. Song. If I'm looking at like my top 15 ever, he's maybe like four of them. No bullshit. That's like, so weird. It is because
that's,
I
just, that's a big deal to me.
I feel like I don't listen to like I'll listen to his albums and like I would say maybe let's just say 40%. I'm like, all right, I really like these songs, and the rest I'm like, I just can't really do it. Like, right. There's nothing wrong with that, but I feel like the ones I really like, I'm like, man, those are always attached to such good memories, and I'm like, man, like, see, there's so many that I don't skip when this song comes on.
He kind of panders, like how he says he has something for everybody type shit. Like, I feel like that's kind of like, I don't know, like he jumps into like everybody's bag. And another thing that I know he does or whatever, because it's kind of been alleged and shit, they're like, he'll get these like, you know, like lesser known artists to kind of jump on their wave and like ride that shit. And because he's Drake, like, you know, that's Drake's wave, like with the Afrobeat shit. You know what I'm saying? Him and Sway Lee always making the same fucking song.
That's kind of like the Kanye thing. He sees the wave. Chris
Montana's wave, really?
But isn't that kind of like the Kanye thing? Like he's good at seeing the wave and he'll jump the ride.
But like, but Kanye, like he's Kanye is like a real producer. You know what I'm saying? So like, I mean, because Kanye has done it with everybody. He has. Like, literally, you aren't lying about that shit. Because he done it with Chief Keef. You know what I'm saying? Yeah. Like, well, remember he changed up the I Don't Like beat and shit like that? You know? Like, so Kanye does do that shit. But I feel like Drake does it kind of on a sneakier level. Like, Kanye will let you have your single and shit, and he'll remix it. You know? And just hop on it or whatever. Drake will do that shit, but people be like, oh, this Drake song. You know what I'm saying? Like,
they're ignorance.
But don't you see that? Well, isn't that kind of like he's putting them on? If they're not,
I mean,
known,
in a way, like he did that shit with I Love McConan, but like, you know, like, where is McConan now?
That's McConan's you know what I'm fault, saying? Though, right?
Party Next Door dropped 2-pack of ass, like Joe Budden said.
I think there's still a lot of people that like them, though.
I mean, yeah, but like he. Drake's just using them for like writing and shit. Like he had them. The OVO sweatshop is not a. Like that's OVO a common sweatshop. Term. Like anyone he signs, really like
a lot of his artists that
he hasn't, sure. And like bro, you've been like for real, you've been the number one like artist for 10 years, bro. Like,
but I feel like, and maybe this is just a bigger.
Even Wang hopped off the boat after 4 years. You know what I'm saying?
Maybe this is just a bigger thing about music in general. But I feel like that's kind of what everybody does now. Where like, I mean, shit, even the NBA, everybody wants to go in, find their place, and build their own empire. Like NBA, like, all right, here's my brand. I'm gonna build this shit around me. Music, I mean, look at all, like,
Rick
QC,
Ross.
You know Quality Control, Rick Ross,
Wale, fucking, who else,
Wale
Rick
was
Ross, Meek Mill, come on, Rick Ross put out a lot of niggas, come
I
on,
get
let's
down Meek Mill, and
Meek Mill was out before Rick Ross, though.
Meek Mill was signed to MMG, what are you talking about?
I know what he's signed to, but I'm saying, who came out first, though?
Rick Ross has been out since 06, since every day I'm hustling.
Yeah, I thought Meek Mill was out for a while.
Meek Mill... Like, Ross put Meek Mill on with Tupac's Back.
Tupac?
Yeah, Tupac. It was a song called Tupac's Back. Tupac's Back. Tupac. It was like 09.
All I remember of Meek Mill was he was in like some pixelated ass image of people. He was in memes for a while. People make fun of his braids.
I think I had Omarion. He had Omarion too for a minute. He like, you know what I'm saying? Had.
Ooh, Rick Ross?
Well, Rick Ross. Put it this way, though.
I know that's he didn't put out Omarion, but
what
he
I'm
had
saying,
Omarion.
My point, though, is everybody tries. I don't think that's an indictment on Drake. Maybe he's not a good judge A&R? Of talent. Maybe he's not a good judge of talent. But, like, you can't fault him for doing that.
Well, his writers write all, like, Cardi didn't write all his shit.
Well, but, like, everybody does that now where they're like, oh, I'm going to start my own team. I mean, shit, Cactus Jack, Travis Scott's got, you know,
Sheck
what?
West.
All of them. And, I mean, they're pretty good. I feel like Sheck West has his own following. I'm not, like, by himself, Don Toliver, but I feel like he was pretty nice on features.
No. Right.
You know, and I'm not the biggest Nav fan, but you know, like, you know.
Nav is whack.
He's on a couple. He's on a couple.
Nav is really whack as fuck, bro.
And I don't get it.
Nav is whack.
I don't like
whack.
Him on solo shit, but like every song that he's a feature on Travis's shit my is a
Nav is on your lip.
Look, Beebs in the Trap, Champion. I ride with both of those songs.
What?
But the point I'm making is, though, like, they all do the same thing. You can't fault for Drake for doing that.
Yeah.
Southern Rock. I mean, I don't know, I just think that I just think Drake is kind of a selfish artist or whatever. Like he's out of
see that.
All the people that like he's mad just selfish, bro. And like even when he like his bitches and shit, like he gets like in his feelings and shit, like you know, like the shit with the Georgia Smith shit, he took out like off the album, you know what I'm saying?
But see, I kind of like that he's like selfish though, because like, I'm like that's a relatable, bitch, bro.
It's not relatable, like it's what you're saying.
I'm like shit, man. Man, relatable. I'm like not using him, but I'm like, hey, it could help me out too, you know. It's kind of like he's just like the new 50, like the opposite side of the spectrum, though.
Yeah.
Like he's all in it for him, but he's not doing it to like doing diss tracks. It's literally the opposite. Like, nah, no diss tracks for me.
I feel y'all. I feel y'all.